Welcome back, Tigers. Setting up campaign member statuses for each campaign can become a tedious task, especially when you have many campaigns going on that are different types with different statuses. Salesforce automatically adds the default statuses of sent and responded to all new campaigns. If you want to customize these, you have to update them manually for each campaign. But never fear, Campaign Member Status Walloper is here. This free AppExchange app is a game changer. It completely automates the process of creating campaign member statuses based on your campaign record type and type. It's super easy to use and can be configured in minutes. So let's hop over to Salesforce and see how this app works. All right, here we are at the AppExchange. I'll provide a link to the Campaign Member Status Walloper app down below in the description. You'll click Get It Now. And then you will install this in your org. You will enter your credentials. And then it's your choice if you want to install for admins only or all users. All right, our installation is complete. So we'll click Done. And then this should take us to our installed packages list, and we can see here that our app is installed. So now we're gonna go to our app launcher, and we will go to the Campaign Member Status Walloper app. And then we'll click on Campaign Member Status Sets. And you can see here that there's only one field showing in this object, which is always really annoying to me. I like to be able to see all of my columns. So I'm gonna go ahead and update the search layouts for this object so that I can see more information about this record, whether or not it's active, maybe the campaign types, the statuses, the created date, created by, whatever columns you think are helpful for you. All right, I'll click save, and then I'll come back here and refresh, and I should see those columns now show. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is create a new campaign member status set. This one is going to be for email. Now, if you have record types enabled in your org for the campaign object, you're going to see an option for you to choose the record type as well as the type. In this org, we do not have any record type set up yet. We are just using the type field. So I will select email in my type. Our create action says, hey, whenever we create a new campaign, what do we want this app to do? Well, I want the app to replace all my campaign member statuses that I'm configuring here. I don't want it to add to the existing ones. Salesforce is gonna add the default statuses of sent and responded. So I don't want those there. I want those removed. And then if the type value changes on the campaign, what do I want this app to do? So I'm gonna set that to be replace all. I'll click save here. And then here's my status set. So I will go into this by clicking on the record name. And then I'm going to click new. And I'm gonna enter all of my statuses that I want to use for my email campaigns. So my first status is sent, and this is my default status. My second status is going to be opened, and this will be second. This is going to be considered a responded status. So if you are using campaign influence and you have responded as one of your filters for your auto association rules, this will be helpful and it'll keep that all standardized. If you don't know what I'm talking about, stay tuned for a video coming up that's going to be all about campaign influence and how to use it. Okay, so our third status is going to be clicked. That is also going to be considered responded. Then I'm going to have a bounced status. And then I'm going to have an unsubscribe status. And this will be my fifth one. I'll click save there. And these are all my statuses. So I'm all set, and I'm gonna click activate. I'll click activate again, and then I am all set. I have activated this status set. Now, if I want to test this out, I can come to the campaign tab and I can create a new campaign. And I'm going to make my type email, and I'll click save. And then I would expect to see my campaign member statuses. get set up exactly how I've configured them in the app. And I can see that it's all set up perfectly. Now, if you wanted to set up sets for your other campaign types, it's very simple. Let's say maybe you had trade show, you would do the same thing. Whatever your default statuses are for your trade shows, you can set those up here. So usually you have attended, maybe they visited your booth. Maybe you had a meeting. Whatever your statuses are, you would configure all of those. And then you would activate. And then here's a good error. An active campaign member status set cannot have a create action as replace all unless there is a default campaign member status. So I did not set any of my statuses to be default here. So let's add a new one on attendee list. So, because sometimes we get a trade show list and they're on that list. And then we can make this 4. And there's my default status. Now I can activate this. Here we go. Perfect. All right, we're all set. That's how you configure the Campaign Member Status Walloper app, one of the best apps on the AppExchange. That's it. That's a wrap. If you have any questions or if you would like to see a tutorial on a different Salesforce topic, let us know in the comments below. And as always, if you like this video, be sure to like, share, and subscribe to Blue Tiger Academy. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.